there's such a gap. You've got a country which has got the youngest population in the world, and you've got some of the oldest politicians. And when I see what's going on in terms of national debate and dialogue, there's a complete disconnect in terms of what children want. So my message to politicians is start listening, otherwise you're going to get voted out of power or there's going to be some sort of revolution. And I'm hoping the revolution will be a ballot box one rather than, you know, on the streets.
I feel like currently we associate wise with old, but a lot of very, very unique ideas come up within the youngsters.
The youth matters, take us into consideration, okay, care about us because we are your future.
Please follow what you say. Don't divert from it. We really want you to also involve youth in politics. It'll really help us out.
I'm the leader of the Communist Party.
I'm the Prime Minister of India. I've been sitting in the Lok Sabha for the past 3 days and we've been discussing child safety with the main focus on cyber safety and cyber security in specific. It's been great. We've talked a lot. We've come up with a lot of points. We've actually passed two bills, one on child labor and one on cyber safety. And honestly, I think the committee is doing really well. There are a lot of first timers here as well who aren't really sure what they're doing, but they're trying their best to contribute. And it's fun to see them learn and watch.
If in 3 days a group of children can sit down, think that they can make a difference by everything that's been collected, I'm sure that the government could do.
All those in favour of incorporating this bill, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say no. It is my pleasure to announce that this bill has been passed by the Lok Sabha.
I've learned a few moral things. That at the end of the day, you just have to agree with people, you just have to compromise somewhere, you just have to find that grey area where you both can agree on, which is what's happening. You've had the communists and you've had the nationalists, and they've been debating with each other for the past 3 days. Then I've learned a lot about the country as well. I've learned a lot about our democracy. I've learned a lot about various aspects of child safety. We've talked about child labour, we've talked about adolescent pregnancy, we've talked about drug abuse, we've talked about juvenile safety, we've talked about cyberbullying, we've talked about ragging.
Cooperation, which is though very, very difficult, can happen. So it's under the, most people think, no, I can't really work with him, but it'll work. Because it's not like a big debate where everybody has sides. The point of an MUN or a model parliament is to come to a solution. And the reason that works right now compared to an MUN is because these solutions are things that affect us. So we realize what the problems are. We can genuinely think of solutions that could help us. We have incentive to work.
You know, I teach the same subject. I teach civics, I teach history, and sometimes it may take me a week to make them understand exactly what the political wings is all about in an Indian system. I was amazed because when I was in the Lok Sabha yesterday, the kids knew exactly who the political wings were, and they also understand real life politics. It's nice to engage in politics. I mean, politics is not a dirty word as we all, you know, seem to portray it, but I think it's beautiful for the simple reason it makes them aware that democracy is all about citizenship. It's their right, you know, and they need to be aware of that.
One statesman who can convince two sides of the argument and actually bring two sides together, and there's another type of statesman that can push his or her perspective through everyone. And I think in our committee, we're seeing both of them. There are many blocks, so there are statesmen who will actually try merging two resolutions there, and there are some who try getting all the votes for themselves. So I think both in a way are good, and both in a way can be successful.
I'm the governor of RBI, and that's one of my dream jobs, so to say. So it really put me in the shoes of the governor of the RBI, and it was interesting to work around what I'll probably do in the future. What more I've learned is that there's a lot in terms of the education, agricultural departments that we really don't do. Like the research really taught me that there's a lot of a gap between what we can do and what we are doing, and that we could bridge the gap through ideas like this where we actually rack up our brains and the youth comes up with solutions.
Personally, for me, I plan to pursue international relations, politics and economics in the future. So, and I think directing a council like this, I can actually know how to lead a group, how to and how to take opinions and not be biased, because I can't get my perspective out here. I might like free market economics, but someone might propose a really good socialist measure, which I'll have to agree. And I can't be biased. So I think that leadership quality is something I can take away from this.
I myself am not a very confident speaker, so I believe that mediums like these can encourage a more debating culture in all our institutions and help us become more confident citizens, so that we can all have a voice, because having a voice is what determines the shaping of the nation.
The biggest learning I'd say from these 3 days would be empathy, honestly, because playing the role of Prime Minister was not easy, honestly, and I also learned a lot from the right-wing ideology, which was my party, and I also learned that the Prime Minister's life is not easy at all. He has to make sure that every ministry is in check. He has to know what's happening in every part of the Parliament at all times, and every ministry needs to know what he's doing so that they can be in collaboration at all times.
Interesting part is that you have a 17-year-old from 12th grade working with someone much younger from let's say 9th or 8th grade. And I think it's just that you meet different people, you meet different perspectives, you try to understand their thought process. I think that's what makes this whole thing so interesting, where you negotiate with each other to arrive at a document, a final consensual document. So that's really the interesting part about this. So the reactions I've had have been very different. Some of them have been very energetic about this. Some of them try to remain silent because they're not confident enough. And that's what we've been trying to do as chairs as well, trying to encourage people to speak up.
I would really like to emphasize on citizenship, because you are part of a country, you have a role, and you have to follow it, and you have a voice to change if you want to change.
I don't think one needs to storm into the houses of the government to make a big change. Simply doing your daily activities and the fundamental duties of a citizen can ensure that you can make a change, and seeing how everyone does their fundamental duties will show people that the governance and government has a purpose, and this will give people a faith in politics and the ability to make a change.